Good morning, students. Welcome back to our social class. We already started our fourth lesson. Do you remember that one? Hope you all followed that video. Yes, our fourth lesson is about our clothes. What is the lesson name? Our clothes. We already discussed about the basic needs. Among those basic needs, clothes is also one of the basic needs. Without clothes, we cannot survive. So clothes, we need clothes. Why do we need clothes? We need clothes to cover our body and to protect us from heat, cold, rain, dust, dirt and insect bites also. Okay children, so we need clothes, not only to cover, to protect ourselves from heat, cold, rain, dust, dirt and insect bites also. Okay children. Okay, in the early human days, there are no clothes. How they live? How they cover their body? They used the skin of dead animals and leaves to cover their body. Later on, the improvements are made and the people started making clothes. They used different materials to make clothes. Okay children, what are the different materials they use? I already told you that people use clothes with different materials. What are the different materials they use? They use cotton, wool, silk. Not only these, there are some artificial fibers also. Some artificial fibers also which are used by the people to make the clothes. Okay children, I told you that people wear clothes according to the weather, according to their place, according to their work and according to the days also. Okay children, here what I told you about the weather. Weather means it will remain, remains for some time and again changes. That we call as seasons. We have three main seasons, that is summer season, winter season and rainy season. What people wear in summer season? They wear cotton clothes. They wear cotton clothes. Okay, in summer season people used to wear cotton clothes. Where, from where they are getting cotton? Cotton ekkada nunchi vastundi valiki? They are getting from cotton plant. Okay children, they are getting from cotton plant. From this plant they are getting cotton cloths and they are cleaned and processed and made into long thin threads and those are made into clothes. Okay children, and where they are getting wool? Wool, what we use to, when it is winter, in winter season what clothes we use? We use woolen clothes. We use woolen clothes. In winter season, we use woolen clothes. And from where it is getting woolen clothes? These clothes are made from wool. From where we are getting this wool? We are getting this wool from fleece of sheep. What it is? Fleece of sheep. Fleece means hair of the sheep. The hair which is on the sheep's body is called the fleece. And not only sheep, we are getting from camels and rabbits also. Okay children, this is the wool which we are getting. And in rainy season, what we use? In rainy season, we use silk clothes. Silk. From where we are getting this silk? We are getting this silk from the silkworm. Silkworm ante oka purugu. And what is the silkworm eats? It eats mulberry leaves. It is mulberry leaves. Okay children, here we are getting cotton from cotton plant and wool from wool and silk from the animals. Okay children, and some artificial fibers are there. Those are also called as man-made fibers. Man-made fibers. Such as, what are those artificial fibers means? Nylon, rayon, polyester, etc. Okay children, all these are the different clothes. Okay, today up till here we learned. Today we are going to learn about the clothes which are used by the people in different places. Means here we are living in India. We are living in India and we are having different states. Do you know in which state we are living? In India we are having different states. Mano ye state lo unnam? We are in Andhra Pradesh. We are in Andhra Pradesh. This is our state. And you know, everywhere we are looking, all the people are wearing clothes. And what is the traditional wear which we are using? What your mother wear? What your father wear? Mothers wear sari and blouse. Yes or no? Here, in our country. In our country, what is the name of our country? India. What is the name of our country? India. In India, where we are living? We are living in Andhra Pradesh. We are living in Andhra Pradesh. This is our state name. Okay. Here, what our mother wear? Mother. Or as women. What are the women wear here? Women wear sari and blouse. Yes or no? And what about the father? Fathers means men. What are the men wear here? What are the men wear? Men wear shirts and pants. These are our traditional dresses. But sometimes people may use different dresses, but these are the main traditional dresses which we are using in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, sarees and blouse for men and shirts and pants for men. In the same way, there are different states in our India, in our country, and each state has its own traditional dress. Okay, according to their place, they wear traditional dresses according to their religious tradition. And here, I have some, see. And now I will show you some different traditional dresses which are used by the people in different places of our country. The first one is here. Look at this picture. What is there? Here, this is the state of West Bengal. This is the state of West Bengal. What the women wear here? See, these are the traditional dresses for these people in West Bengal. The woman wears white sari with a red border sari. Okay, with a red border. She wears the white sari and with a red border. And this is the traditional wear for women. And the men wear pajama and dhoti. This is a pajama and dhoti dress for the people in West Bengal. Okay, children, is it clear for you? Children, here this is the traditional wear for West Bengal. And here this is the traditional wear for Kashmir, the state of Kashmir. Here it is the home of variety, different fashions. Okay, children, they wear different fashions. Here, the woman wears parents. There is a difference in Hindu women dresses and Muslim women dresses. Here, in Kashmir, there are two religions, Amma, Hindu religion and Muslim religion. Hindu women dresses differ from the Muslim women religion. Okay, children, here this is the type of dress which they wear in Kashmir. And here men wear parents with turbans. They use this one on their head. They use the overcoat model dress also. Here they use the these type of shoes. Okay, children, this is the dresses of state of West Bengal and Kashmir. Now here, let us see the another traditional dresses of different states. Here, this is the state of Gujarat. In Gujarat, women wear chanio
and choli. It is also called as ghagra choli. And long dupattas as veils on their heads. It is also called odhni. It is also called as odhni. And men wear chudidar pyjamas and vibrant turbans. Here, it is called as turban, which is wearing on their head. Okay, children. Here, this is the traditional dress of the Gujarat state, and this is Rajasthan. Rajasthan states. Here, the people wear these type of dresses. Means the women wear ghagra choli with a long skirt, and the top is called as crop top. Nowadays we are also using in Andhra Pradesh, and it is also called as kurtis. Okay, children, and the men will wear dhoti and angaraka, or it is also called as kurta and paijama with pagar and or safa. This is called as pagar or safa, the which one he is wearing on his head. Okay, children, these are the different clothes used in Gujarat and Rajasthan. Okay, children. Here, these are the different traditional methods which are using in the state of Punjab and Kerala. Punjab and Kerala. Here in Punjab, people used to wear salwar kameez. The women. Women wear salwar kameez. It is and also patiala salwar, and they use scarves or dupattas on their head. Sometimes they may use ghagras also. Okay, children, and these are the dresses of men in Punjab, and people they use kurta pyjamas, or it is also and pagris. It is a different style of shoes called juti. Okay, the shoes are called as juti. These are the different traditional methods which they use while wearing their clothes. Okay, and here it is in the state of Kerala. In Kerala, women wear mostly saris. Okay, children, they mostly made by Kanchipuram silk and Banaras silk saris. They used to wear Kanchipuram silk saris or Banaras saris. Here, this is the way they tie their saris. And men wear mundu. Men wear mundu. Mundu means it is a state of version of lungi. They call it as mundu. Manavaithe lungi antam. But they use mundu, and it is a casual wear and religious wear also. And mamulga kuda veskuntaru, pandagala appudu kuda ide veskuntaru. They use mundu. This is called as mundu. Okay, this is the way of the dress which they use in state of Kerala. Okay, children. Here, this is Punjab state. Punjab people use this type of, and Kerala state people use these type of dresses. Okay, children. And now, here, see this picture. Here in Maharashtra, people use these type of dresses, and in Assam state, people use these type of dresses. In Maharashtra, women wear saris paired with cholis. Here, see, this is the way how they tie their saris. And men wear dhoti paired peta or pagada. It is called as pagada. Okay, this is the different traditional method which the people use in Maharashtra. By seeing there the way of dressing, we can easily tell about this place, about the place where they live. Okay, and here this is the Assam state. Here the women wear mekhala and saris. It is a combination of different tribes. In Assam, there it is a combination of different tribes. So, according to the tribes, the people used to wear the clothes, and men wear dhoti. Okay, children, these are the different clothing methods which they use to wear. And these are the traditional. Religious clothes which the people wear in different states. Here I wrote about them detailedly.
First, once again, listen. I already shown the pictures also. I'm explaining about those pictures in West Bengal, the state of West Bengal. The women wear saris, and the material which is used to make the saris are silk, tanned cotton, and chiffon. Okay, and the women wear white saris with red border. It is the religious traditional wear. Okay, children. They use these type of saris for their religious festivals mostly. And the men wears Punjabi with pajama and dhoti is also called as dhoti. And the state of Kashmir, women wear there are two religions, Hindu religion and Muslim religion. And Hindu religion women wear saranga, and whereas Muslim women wear abhaya. Okay, these are the different names which have given to their dresses. And the men wear faran with turbans. Turbans means on the head they used to wear a cap, that is called as turbans. And in the state of Gujarat, the women wear chanyo choli or ghagra choli. It is also called as ghagra choli. They use the long dupattas on their head. Long dupattas. And the men use dhoti andharka, or it is also called as kurta pajamas with pagar. Pagar means it is also a cloth which is used on their head. Tamil pettukune cap la untadi, it is called as pagar. Then it harbun an kuda antamma. Okay children, and the state of Rajasthan, in Rajasthan women wear ghagra cholis and also called as kurtis an kuda antaru. Okay, and the men wear dhoti angarika with pagars. In the same way, Gujarat lo unnante Rajasthan lo kuda men same dresses avadu vesukuntaru, and they use the turbans on their head. Okay, it is also called as safa an kuda antaru. Okay children, these are the different traditional dresses which are used in some states, and two more states are there, let me discuss. In Punjab state, in the state of Punjab, women wear salwar kameez, patiala salwars, and scarves also. Scarves and dupattas on their head, and they also use the ghagras. Okay, and the men wear kurta pajamas, pagri, and different types of shoes called as juti. The different styles of shoes which are using are called as juti. Okay children, and in state of Kerala, the women wear saris, and the material which is used to made are Kanchipuram silk or Banaras silk saris they use, and the men uses mundu. What it is? It is mundu, and it is also called as lungi. It is also called as lungi. It can be used for casual wear or religious wear also. Even in festivals also they used to wear mundu. Okay children, and here see some of your states. Children, here in Maharashtra, in the state of Maharashtra, the women wear saris and paired with cholis. Okay children, and the men wear dhoti, paired peta and pagada. Okay children, these are the different costumes which they use. And Assam, in the state of Assam, it is a combination of different tribes. There the people, different tribes of people are living there. Everyone use their different dresses. Some women mostly wear mekhala and saris, and men wear dhotis. Okay children, these are the different states which the people used to wear these different dresses. Those are also called as costumes. Okay children, and not only in our country, all over the world the people used to wear dresses according to their place which they live. And in our next video I will tell about those dresses. Okay children, thank you.